The Legend of Zelda, Ocarina of Time, a true 90s classic, now running natively on PC, and more specifically for the purposes of this video, Linux and Steam Deck. This reverse-engineered project is called Ship of Harkinian, or SOH. So the question arises, why play Ocarina of Time on native hardware as opposed to using emulation? There's quite a number of reasons and a myriad of benefits. First of all, you can go well beyond the 20 FPS slideshow of the original game. This native port delivers frame rates that are as high as your monitor's refresh rate, giving you a buttery smooth gameplay experience, and the same is true for resolutions. This port also offers adjustable difficulty options, including how much damage you take or enemies that move at a faster pace. There's a plethora of quality of life improvements, such as faster text scrolling through lengthy dialogue, faster walking speeds, and not having to sit through Link playing a song on his ocarina every single time. Another killer improvement is that you don't have to wait 5 minutes for King Zora to move his ass out of your way. There's a wide variety of enhancements too, from the color of Link's tunic, gyroscopic aiming when using the slingshot and bow, and a camera that allows you to move it freely like any modern 3D game. There's also a built-in randomizer, shuffling the in-game items and enemies, giving you a fresh gameplay experience every time. And one of the best options that comes along with the PC, mod support. That's right, this release includes the ability to swap out Link's model as well as other meshes like his sword and the support for assets from the 3DS remake. If, on the other hand, you want as authentic of an N64 experience as possible, SOH gives you these options too. You can run the game at 20 FPS, decrease the resolution to make the graphics more pixelated, and whatever else you want to do to more closely resemble 90s hardware. So now that you know what Ship of Harkinian is, here's how to get SOH running on Steam Deck. So let's talk about requirements, because you're going to need a little bit to get this running. In addition to a soft-modded Wii or Wii U, you'll also need a legal copy of the European or Australian version of Zelda Collector's Edition for the GameCube. You can also use a PAL N64 cartridge, but dumping that will be outside the scope of this tutorial. The reason that you need the PAL version, according to the SOH FAQ, is that the decomp started as a debug version because debug statements helped in identifying functionality during the decomp process. The only debug version available was PAL. Now, if you don't happen to have a copy on hand, well, good luck trying to buy one on eBay without breaking the bank. Needless to say, we don't condone piracy of the disk image or ROMs. Now, you'll need a Steam Deck, or you can do this on a Linux machine. If you're using the Steam Deck, you'll definitely want to have a keyboard and mouse connected to your deck because it just makes everything so much easier. You can use a USB-C dock or a Bluetooth mouse and keyboard. The choice is up to you. But now that we have the requirements out of the way, let's get to dumping. Now, dumping this game is going to be a bit of a process. You can't just dump it from your Wii or Wii U and call it a day. It's going to require using the Dolphin emulator to extract a specific file from the ISO, and then using a Hex editor to extract a specific portion of that file. Follow the instructions over on the Wii guide to help you dump the disk. An easy way to dump your disk is using CleanRip via the Homebrew channel. Transfer the ISO to your Steam Deck or your PC of choice. In this case, I put the ISO in my emulation ROM GameCube directory. If you don't already have Dolphin installed, you can install it with EmuDeck or use the command on screen right now. Open Dolphin under the Games category in the Start menu, select the ROM file path if you haven't already, right-click Zelda Collector's Edition from the ROM list, and go to Properties. Go to the File System tab all the way to the right, expand the category for TGC in the file browser, right-click Zelda underscore PAL underscore 093003.tgc, and select Extract File. Extract the TGC file to your downloads directory. Now this is where things get a little convoluted. You're going to need to use a hex editor for this part, as we need to extract a specific portion of hex code and save it as a .z64 file. While there are plenty of hex editors available as flat packs, none of them that we tried have the feature that we need for this guide. So we have to resort to what the official SOH dumping guide recommends, and that is HXD. Now, head over to the download page for HXD, download the installable edition appropriate for your region, and after downloading the zip file, extract it. Now we're going to need bottles, so let's get that installed. Use the command on screen to do that. Run bottles under the utilities section of the Start menu. Click Create New Bottle and give the bottle a name, leaving the environment to Application as it is. click create. Let bottles do its thing for a minute, and it should be ready after a few seconds. Click close when done. Click run executable in the file select window. Go to the location where you extracted the HXD installer and select it. It should be hdxsetup.exe or something similar. Now we're going to walk through the installer, leave the settings as is, and make sure both create a desktop shortcut and create a quick launch shortcut are unchecked. Within Bottle, you should now see HDX listed under Programs. Simply click the Play button and the program should now be open. Click File, Open, My Computer, select the Z drive, go to Home, Deck, and then Downloads. Find Zelda PAL 093003.tgc, and now open it. You should see a bunch of hex data on the screen at this point. Go to Edit, select Block, and then put in 1C6697C0 in the Start Offset field, and then for Length, set it to 2 million. Make sure that Hex is selected. Click OK, and the raw bytes of the ROM should now be selected. Copy the selected data with Ctrl-C, create a new file with Ctrl-N, paste the copied data with Ctrl-V, and you will likely get a message telling you that the operation will change the file size. Click OK to proceed. With me so far? We're almost done here. Save the new file with Ctrl-S in the file window, give the name any name that you want, just make sure that it ends with .z64. In our case, we named the file zelda_oot.z64. Now congrats, we have our ROM file and we've dumped it legally. Now the hardest part is out of the way. Go ahead and close HDX and bottles. To verify the extracted files, head over to the SOH compatibility checker, click load a ROM, and select the Z64 file that you just saved. If the verification process worked, then the page should tell you what version of the game you just dumped. Now, we need to download SOH. It's available natively on Linux and Steam Deck as an app image. So let's go to the releases section on their GitHub page, and under the assets category, there are two different app images to choose from, compatibility and performance. For this guide, we're going to go with performance. Download the zip file and extract it here. There should be an soh.appimage file now. Right-click the app image, go to Properties, and under the Permissions tab, check its Is Executable button, and then click OK. If everything went well, then your Z64 file should be in the same directory as the app image for SOH. SOH will extract some files and then run the game. Great, you can now close the game. Now, you can feel free to move these files to any directory you want so that they're not clogging up your downloads directory. Right-click the app image again and select Add to Steam to add it to your non-Steam games. In the future, if there's an update for SOH, simply download the app image for a newer version and overwrite the existing app image. Your save data will be intact. So let's go back to game mode and let's get rid of this ugly gray bog standard icon for any game that gets added to your library. We need to install DeckyLoader and SteamGridDB to do this in an efficient way. I've made a video about that up here. I'm not gonna go into that in this video. Go to the app in your non-Steam library, then press Start and select Properties. We're gonna change the name from soh.appimage to Ship of Harkinian. Close out the Properties window, and with SOH selected in your library and with DeckyLoader and SteamGridDB installed, press Start again, and then select Change Artwork. Now we can add some artwork to the game. You can do whatever you want here with the art. You can use stuff that's already ready-made, or you can make one for yourself. The choice is yours. But now we're ready to go. We have the game installed in game mode, and we can get this thing up and running. Now we do have some recommendations for running the game here as far as controls go. We would recommend enabling the back grip buttons. Set one of them to F1 so that you can access the menu, and another to F11 so that you can enter or exit full screen. Enable gyro controls and set it to joystick mode, as SOH doesn't seem to pick up on gyro as mouse at the moment. You can also set the right trackpad as a mouse, with right trackpad click set to a left mouse click, and the left trackpad as a scroll wheel so you can scroll through various menus that SOH provides. After that, we have some in-game recommendations too. You can enable free camera in settings, controller, additional controller options. Note that you will need to reconfigure the C buttons and set them to a button instead of a right stick tilt, and assign right stick to, well, being a right stick. For some battery savings, you can set the TDP limit and GPU clock frequency all the way down to 3 watts and 200 megahertz respectively. Even at 60 FPS, it will run great. Set MSAA to 8 and match the FPS to the refresh rate of the screen via the settings graphics tab. There are quality of life improvement presets as well. Under the enhancements tab in the settings, set the preset to enhanced, and this will result in faster block pushing and item pickup messages being skipped. You can change the difficulty settings too, such as increasing damage taken and or hyper enemies for a more challenging experience. You can mute the low HP alarm, you can use the minimal UI, you can disable Navi call audio, finally, no more, hey, listen! There are a couple of mods over on Game Banana. Mods will allow you to change Link's model, you can upgrade the textures to the 3DS remake, you can adjust the HUD to use different icons, and other things. And mods are really cool, so check out some of the mods that are available with the links in the description. And that's how you enjoy Ocarina of Time natively on your Steam Deck. Use the links below to find out more about this project. You can also check out Linux Gaming Central's write-up on this, which this is a collab between him and I. So go check that out if you want a more detailed overview of the mods, for example. Thank you so much for everybody watching this video. I really appreciate you being here, and I'll see you guys in the next one.